Moin and let's play it again. Today I show you how to get crazy patterns on your 3D prints and what you need to do it, like this Mandalorian Beskar steel. Relax, sit back, and it's going a little bit complicated, but have fun. Just have fun. First, you need a 3D print, of course. Make sure that you do not model the pattern. It will be plated later. Then print the whole thing. To metal plate it shiny, the object must be very smooth, so I will now work on it with filler spray and sandpaper. Before we spray the print with a conductive varnish, I apply a layer of polyurethane to prevent the filler from dissolving. There are several ways to make it electrically conductive. I tend to use acetone and copper lacquer. Please clean the print before application. Now grab some silver wire and steel wool, then clean the wire thoroughly with it. Now wrap it around your conductive 3D print, like so. The next step is the Bass electroplating with copper electrolyte. I have already described this in detail in a few videos. Just click here in the top corner or look for a link in the description. The next step is the brush plating. For this I use a graphite anode to deposit palladium on the fresh copper. This process is also described in detail in my previous videos, so maybe you have a look. With this method, a thin layer of, for instance, palladium can be deposited on the copper. Looks good. This is the starting point for the next steps. To plate the pattern, we will now mask the palladium. First, we apply a thin layer of positive photoresist. This layer should dry for 24 hours. Since UV light destroys the varnish, it must always be kept dark. Now we can transfer our pattern into the varnish by exposing it with an UV source. First, we create a graphic with the correct dimensions, print it out black and white with a lot of ink, and fix two of them exactly on top of each other. Before we expose it, we need to mix the developer liquid. Be absolutely sure to protect your hands and eyes, this stuff is very corrosive. It is a sodium hydroxide solution. Add 3.5 grams to 500 milliliters of water and stir until it dissolves. This amount applies to my varnish. It may be that you need a different ratio for others. Now we need a UV source. Sure, daylight works too, but I found an old sunbed with which I have enough UV radiation in 1 minute to dissolve the paint in the places where no light comes. So we put the foils on the 3D print, weigh the whole thing down with a glass plate, and then it's placed under the UV light. Then the foil is removed and the exposed object is gently swirled in the sodium hydroxide solution. The varnish now comes off the palladium in exactly those spots that were not protected from the UV light with black ink. When everything is dissolved, stop the process by rinsing it in clear water. Now we just have to plate over the whole part with the galvanic brush. I now use chrome electrolyte and a nickel anode for this. When plating, I go with a relatively high voltage on the print. This makes the deposited chrome very dark, perfect for the effect. The remaining varnish ensures that no chrome is deposited at these points. please do this only in well-ventilated areas. Finally, you can rinse it off with distilled water. Now the remaining photoresist can be removed too. I used an acetone-based thinner for this. The metal now looks a bit dull, that's why I oil the surface a little. It looks great, and that brings us to the end. I know the result can be achieved in many different ways, for example with vinyl cutters and or electro etching, but I thought that an alternative way could be shown. Oh, one more thing. I had asked early on Twitter who could tell me what it would be in the end, and the only single person who answered also guessed it correctly. I have now placed this profile pic on the back of the Beskar Steel. Lucky guy, it's a gift for you. I hope you liked it. If you want, subscribe to my channel. Moin moin!